Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at how we can incorporate some conditional logic into our form templates in Dashpivot. And this is going to help us to trigger additional fields to appear on our forms under certain conditions. So an example might be if we select yes to a certain question, then we show some additional questions. If we select no, then nothing happens, or maybe a different set of questions appear. So we're going to cover the basics in this video, how to set it up and how to use it both on the website and in the mobile app. So here we are on the Dashpivot website, and we have a site diary template already set up. It doesn't have any logic applied yet, so I just want to show you, if we open this up and create a new diary, we have a pretty straightforward site diary report here. So we have date, location, summary, etc. Down the bottom, we've got two questions: were there any delays on site today, and do any variations need to be recorded, processed, and approved? Now, what might be useful here is that if we select yes, we might want to prompt for some additional information, such as when did the delay occur, who was involved, were there any photos, things like that. But those fields probably aren't applicable 95% of the time, because you're not experiencing delays on a daily basis. So you kind of don't want to show those fields all the time, but when they're important, you definitely want to have them in the form. So this is what conditional logic will help you achieve. So if we can set it up so that if we select yes, then it shows those additional questions. And we can do this for multiple fields and have multiple fields appear with logic included below. So let's take a look at how we can set this up. We need to click Edit Template, and in the Template Builder, we scroll down and you can see that we've got these two questions here. Now, these two fields are using the Yes, No field, and this field can have logic applied. We know that because it's actually got this little logic icon displayed here. So the Yes, No question has logic available. The List field also has logic available. In this example, they're both yes, no questions. So you can see here, were there any delays on site today? If we hover on the field, the Add Logic button appears just below. So if we click it, it then allows us to set some conditions to define in what circumstances we want to show some additional questions. And then in the drag and drop area, we can then add in the fields that we want to show. So in our case, if the answer is yes, so if the value equals yes, then show these fields. And we might just drag in a text field for a description. We might add in a date field that is set to be a date and time range for the duration of the delay. And we might add in a photo field at the bottom as well. And what's really powerful about this is that we can make it so that maybe answering this delays question is required. And then if we show these additional fields, so if there were some delays, we definitely want to capture some additional information. So we're definitely going to want to know the duration of the delay and a description, and maybe the photos, maybe you make it required, maybe you don't. It's really up to you. But in this example, let's say that we want to definitely capture that information. And so we can do this, we can repeat this process. So we could do we can do something similar for variations. We can click Add Logic, and then we can add in a field for description. And let's just leave it at description for now. And maybe this one isn't required, but it is required to answer the question, but it's not required to give a response for whatever reason. So great. So now that we've made those changes in here, let's click Save. Oops. We just needed to define one last thing. So we needed to specify that under what condition do we show these fields. So it's if the value equals yes. So did any variations need to be recorded or processed? Yes, we're going to show these fields. Great, so let's click Save. And let's take a look at what this looks like when one of our team members now goes to fill out this form. So we click Add Diary. Like we did before, we get all the same stuff up the top. And if we scroll down, our two fields are now marked as required. And let's see what happens when we click yes. So if we click yes, the additional fields show up just below. And you'll notice that if we select yes and then we try and save, it doesn't actually let us save because we need to fill out these required fields that have now shown up on the page. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's say that it is today and the time is from 4 o'clock to 4:30 is the duration. There was a traffic delay. We could add in some photos if we'd like. And you can see that as we fill those out, the required fields are going away, the red highlighting. And then below, variations, do any variations need to be approved? If we clicked yes, then you can see the additional field appears, but we don't have to fill it out. If we click no, then the fields go away. And the same thing could happen up here. So if we clicked no, these fields would then disappear. And then if they're not shown, they're not required. So once we've done that, we can click save. Just click save. And you can see that we've got our form sitting in here now. So let's take a look at what this looks like in the mobile app. I've got my app hooked up to the computer here. And we're in the template section, so let's click on that diary again. We can see that's the form that we just filled out. Let's create a new one. Scroll down, and you can see we've got those same questions, delays, variations. Let's select yes, and you can see straight away those additional fields show up. So we could go ahead and select the duration of the delay, add in a description. And what's good is that because we're in the app, we can then take a photo if we want to. Take a photo of my water bottle. Click next, save it. It's then added into the form. So, and again, for variations, we could click yes and show the fields. We could click no, and then it changes what's shown. Once we're happy with all of that, we just click the save button, and it saves it straight into Dashpivot. We get the upload complete message once it's been synced with the website. And so now that form is good to go. So you can see that we've now got two forms in here for our site diary. If we come back to the website, there's two last things I want to show you in this video. The first is relating to register view. So if we click on register, you can see those two forms are here. I want to show you that if we click edit columns, this is where we see all of the fields that could be displayed. And you'll see that the fields that are displayed when certain logic is met, those are sort of indented. So you can see this is the question, delays, were there any delays on site today? So that's our question field. And then there's some additional logic that could show up under this condition. So if the logic equals any of these values, then these fields are the ones that are shown. And we can turn them on and off just like we can with any of the other fields. We just go ahead and make those changes. Same with variations, the same thing. So basically every time that we have some a field that has some conditional logic written in, any of the fields that show up as a result of that will show up here in the register view settings. But you can see, yeah, that they're indented. So yeah, that's the register view. Last thing I want to show you is what happens when we export the information. So if we open up our form again, you can see here's the form that we filled out with the photo of the drink bottle. If we download this as a PDF, it's going to open up a new tab, and you can see it's just downloading, so it might just take a second. It does have a photo on it, so let's just give it a moment. Okay, great. So it's good to go. So we click download, and if we open it up, you can see that we have all the usual fields, but you'll notice that the fields that are shown as a result of logic are just slightly indented. So it just makes it a bit easier to see which fields are displayed as a result of this conditional logic and which ones are just the regular fields. So just wanted to make you aware of that. And that's it for this video. That's how you can use conditional logic inside of your form templates in Dashpivot. We do have some other tutorials and videos and articles in the tutorial section covering other features and functionality that we have available, as well as different use cases. So please feel free to check that out. But if you get stuck with anything or have specific questions, you can always reach our team via live chat on the website and in the Dashpivot app as well. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.